That's what I want to get to. So you should now see events, attendees, invitation, and
that is correct.
An account. Perfect. Okay. So I'll click on events.
Okay.
And you should see this drop down events, archives, and so forth. And the place that you're going to go, 10 out of 10 times will be regional events. And once you click on that, it'll do the drop down and you'll go to South Central.
Okay, I am there.
And you should now see the wine tasting and the October. Okay. So one of the things that makes this the easiest way to do this is rather than start an event from scratch, I almost always copy something that I set up that I knew was good in terms of layout and that's similar in nature to the thing that you're doing now.
Okay.
So, wine tasting on Fredericksburg, is that something you did or somebody else
helped? Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it's something that we put together.
You did last year.
Yes, sir.
So let's copy that. And to do that, you'll see over on the right-hand side, there's a edit button, which is the little edit form pencil. And then the next one over is copy it.
Okay, got it.
Okay, go ahead. I'm not going to do it because I don't want to, because...
I'm doing it. Okay, yeah. This will create a copy of the event. This might take a few minutes depending on the complexity of the event. Okay.
Yep, go ahead and say yes to that.
Okay, I copied it, and it says testing, and he did copy it. Okay.
So now you can go into it, and if you go over to the right-hand side, you'll see the little edit button.
Yes, sir. I'm there now.
Okay, and go ahead and open that up.
Peter, thank you for your time, sir.
No, this is no problem. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to switch over, since I want you to be working on your computer, I'm going to switch this over and give you control. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is change the event title to what you want to call it. Oops.
I'm going to my email so I can start maybe working on the text. Okay.
Good idea. Yeah. So open that up and put it off to the side. Okay.
Okay.
Perfect. So it is a public event, so leave that, and then take the event the description, and you can erase that whole one that's in there.
Okay. Perfect. Perfect.
Go back to your email, and you may be able to just pull that paragraph out.
Yeah, we're going to put all of the details or just the description?
I would just keep it that description. So you're going to do a much more detailed one in the website that you create for this. Building. This is just the information that they get when they actually get to the registration. So you want it to be sort of a descriptive information, but it doesn't have to have a ton of information.
Okay.
Then you're going to put in the location. So you have a specific location that this is going to be at, which is at that
plantation.
Yeah, I do this all the time. Basically, this is a lot of tabbing to various things to get the Booker online. So there's the 800 number. You could grab that. Or if there's an actual, that's served. You don't want to give them that one. Yep. There's their telephone down there, the 225-473.
Yep.
And then you're going to need the address in a second, so just leave that, pop over, back over, drop in the phone, and then grab the address line.
Let's see if we can.
Yeah, I just grabbed that the 40.
Okay.
There you go.
The city is actually Gonzales. The let's just double check.
We'll actually do a map to the place, so you want you want it accurate. So you want Darrow, Louisiana, and you want River Road in there too, because that way it'll spot this thing.
Okay.
Hopefully. March
21st and the next day.
Yeah, it's just one night, right?
Yes, sir. Oh.
Yeah, just a little arrow, yeah. And on a start time, what I do is I just do it at the, you have a specific time you want people to be there. So the you're already in Central Time, so that's good. Just pick the appropriate 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock. And ends at noon.
Noon the next day. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So do you know what you're going to charge?
Yes, $155.
Okay. And that's just for the dinner, right?
That's for the dinner. We got the dinner, the drinks before, all of that.
Okay.
Did you see the description of the event?
I skimmed it, I must admit. Okay. I didn't go through it in detail.
I put 40. I don't know if we're going to get that. But
How many rooms do they have available at this location?
They have rooms for 15. They have 15 rooms available. They don't have them on a block. But they are available. So maybe put 20.
Yeah. So if you got 15 rooms, that means that your goal per person is going to be to fill it. But generally, I wouldn't. So you got 15 rooms. I would put like 12 or 20, 25 probably.
Yeah.
Or 24 would be a good number since you got.
Yeah. It's double. Okay.
Yeah, so
all right.
Because this fee, you're not going to do the hotel itself. They have to do that.
They have to do the hotel. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then change that to something more appropriate. So SC Mississippi Spring.
Let's see. Let's do this. I think what let's do.
You can make this anything you want. Just no spaces.
Huh?
No spaces.
Okay. Spring. Okay.
Yeah. And is there space between the C and the M?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Get rid of that.
Okay.
Okay. That's good. So that's. That the www.regonline.com and that is how you can reference this before you send it live.
Okay.
This allows then if you want someone like myself or Gil or somebody to take a look at this before you do it live, you can send them the link to this address and they can add it and do a test.
Okay, I'm.
Okay, so the rest of this, it's an event, social networking, entertainment, that's all. You can just leave those alone. And you're not going to have different registration types. There's just one
yes.
type of registration. Everybody is going to be the same, right? You don't have a kid's meal or anything like that
right.
you have to worry about. So I would click on actually, I don't think you need to even add that. You're going to allow group registrations because there's going to be multiple people that come together in a plane.
Okay. Yes.
And basically what each person would pay the $155.
Yes.
Okay. And there's no group discount. You have a target up above a 24. But what you want to do is limit the number of registrants for this event because you don't want to have more than the number of hotel room spaces available, right? So So this would be 30, right? If they've got 15 rooms.
Yeah, but we're going to have some local people that might not, that are not going to stay.
Oh, okay. That's possible. That's right.
So how about if we put them on 40?
Put 40, yeah.
Okay.
And if you want to, you can click on the event full message, and that'll bring up another box where you can edit that. And one of the things that your choices are is to add more information to this if there's a wait list or stuff like that.
Okay. I don't think it's necessary.
Yeah, that's it basically just says, you know, sorry, you're out of, you know, we're out of space.
Yeah. Okay.
And click done on that. And then, so you're not going to enable a wait list.
Correct.
You don't have to worry about the require password. Confirmed is fine. And scroll down to the bottom there. A little bit farther. There we go. Okay. So then the link options, you're going to have this links to the homepage of Cirrus Pilots. So you want to leave that. And you're going to create a website, but not separate. So you don't have to click on that. If you had like a totally separate website that you were going to create for this event, then you could link it with that checkbox, but you don't have to. We're going to do just a little baby website that will be up first when people look at this.
Okay.
And then the header and footer options, I wouldn't leave alone. So click save. And if there's anything that it didn't like, it's going to come back and tell us, but I think you got everything that it needs. Okay, good. Then scroll down to the bottom again and go to next. Okay. So this is where it asks basic information. So when you register, it's going to collect information for you. And yes. You can make this as detailed as you want. Obviously, the ones on the left checkboxes are things which they can enter in. The things that are unchecked, they won't see. And the things that you must have them fill out are checked on the right-hand side. So you'll see that all this is being required are three things right now: the first name, last name, and a cell phone. And that might be all you get from some people. So if you want more information, so for example, are you going to print name badges for people when they, you know, when they come in? And if you, then you'd want to check that and make it a requirement.
And the city that they're coming from. Okay.
Yeah. What I typically do, particularly if you're doing a dinner, is I go down to the additional fields area. If you're going to require city, what I would probably do is check off, just get their full address. That may be actually useful from the point of view of state and zip code become required. And you can ask for gender if you want to. That's often not a bad thing to do if you want that. If they're going to be flying in, you want to know that. So you want to, in my mind, there's two things that you really want to know. You want to know if they're flying in, what their tail number is, just so you can track it. And on the dinner, if there's any type of special dietary considerations that they would have.
We are not going to do that.
You're not going to do that? Okay.
So, we're not going to offer that. But I don't see the feel for the choice if they're flying in.
So you have down at the bottom, you have the airplane registration. So that's already set up. So if they fill that in, it's not required, but if you fill, what you can do is add a custom field and make it a required field and make it a checkbox. And the field can be something like, are you flying to this event or something like that? And then have a checkbox, which is the default, and you just need to make it required.
Okay.
And spaces available would be just one. And then save that.
And then you want me to add the tail number?
I think it's already there, actually.
Okay.
Okay, done. And then that should show up now. You'll see that you have the airplane registration and that are you flying. So what you could do, since it makes more sense to ask the required field first and then have the registration, is you can actually drag that line above the registration one.
This one?
Yep.
I can just drag it up?
Yep. Click on it, hold the left button and drag it up. And it's a little tricky. Click on the checkbox area. Yeah, see, that opened it. Click and hold where it says checkbox, not where you're pointing right now. And then it should, there you go. And then it should allow you to move it above.
Yep,
there you go. That's
okay, great.
That's the way you organize that to be what you want it to be.
Yes.
And go edit, click on the airplane registration one. So to open that up. No, that'll copy it.
No. I'm sorry.
Cancel that. Just click where it has the blue for airplane registration.
Yeah.
Okay, so that has registration and number. It's a line of text, character limit 6. Okay, good. And shows currently own item when registrants select item below, personal information page. So click into that. Okay, and then check that box. Okay.
Perfect.
So that way it will only show that if they check off that they are flying to the event.
I got you.
So
okay.
That's very cool. It makes a logical,
flow.
Yep, logical flow. Okay, you're done with that.
Okay. This is awesome that we're recording this.
Okay. So scroll down a little farther. Don't think we have anything else. Page name, personal information. Okay, click next. So you don't really have any agendas. This is not an agenda thing. If you had an agenda where there were different options for them to do different things, and they tell you which things they're going to do, this would be a place to put it.
Okay.
This would be typically if, like a migration where you have, all different things that are available to them, and you can put different pricing on the items and stuff like that.
Okay.
Okay, so skip that. If you don't put anything in here, it will skip this.
Okay, so next?
Yep, next. So this next one is to provide the booking URL for the hotel. So RegOnline will actually tie in to that. However, what I have found is that it's fairly limited to that. You don't need to tell you the truth. If you're simply saying you're going to charge for the dinner,
yes.
you can,
there's no need
to set up the hotel. This is really good. Again, if you're doing migration and there's a bunch of hotels and you got to book them and stuff like that, and you want to capture airline information and, you know, all these things. We don't do, you don't really need.
Okay, so I'm going to go next.
Click next.
Right?
Yep.
Yes, sir. Okay, merchandise, no merchandise?
Nope, no, if you're not selling any shirts, stuff.
Okay, all right,
and
checkout.
The credit card checkout point, you're going to allow them to do this with credit cards. And,
correct.
Is there going to be a refund option? So for an example, if somebody decides the day before that they can't make it, are you going to give them their money back? Or
what is always at a loss, because the restaurant is saying that we need to give them a firm count 4 days prior, and then we're locked whether one person shows up or everyone shows up.
And the refund policy is you must let us know at least 5 days prior to the event that you are coming. So if you're on the hook for 4 days, I always give myself a buffer.
Yes.
You know, you never know. And and that would be the message that you would put under the refund policy. So click on the policy message there.
And what would you suggest that I write?
Exactly what you just said. The restaurant refunds. Yeah, that's good. Refund will be issued only with notice.
5 day notice?
Yeah, five day
notice.
5 day notice prior to that.
Sounds good?
Yep, that's simple.
Okay, so we do have we have that set. Okay.
Okay. If you're going to charge them the service fee sharing, but recently, I think we renegotiated our RegOnline deal.
Yes.
So I don't know. I think that lowered our overall cost. You know, this is actually one of the questions I have for Gil. I have typically not added the RegOnline service fee to the registrant's total. I figure that's my buffer. So one of the things that I would typically do is if your cost, so you're going to pay the restaurant $155 per person.
I'm going to pay the restaurant $140.
You've got your 10% factored in already.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's what if I'm going to do a 10% increase on their overall fee, then I, you know, the service fee, I don't charge them that.
Okay, then I'm going to go next. Okay, you want me to open it?
Open it back up again.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay, go to the registration form.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, and then do preview. Okay. So you've got, you just want to review all the information.
Okay. My telephone number is incorrect.
Yeah,
it's 702.
Yeah, so it the phone number we'll have to go figure out where that is still in,
where that came from,
and where that's coming from. And you notice lodging information is still there.
Yes.
So the Hangar Hotel is wrong. That's
yes.
Part of the problem when you edit you copy from something else. Okay.
Yes, sir. Now, let's see, we're speaking up the, maybe it's
So go to lodging, go to lodging and travel.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's the hangar hotel. So hit the garbage can. That gets rid of that.
Do you want to put here the name of the hotel?
We could do that.
Okay, so let's just.
So there you go. Yep. So just change the name. Drop in their website. Note the full HTTP. Yeah, you need the full link.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, select up on top and copy that. And that should.
Oh, Peter, thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
Oh, let me double check that. 2-5.
Okay, go back up to that address line one.
Yes, sir.
And scroll to the, click into it, and then hit your left arrow, right arrow. Go to the right. You want to get.
Yes, sir.
You copied the entire address in there.
Yes, sir.
And you don't want that. That'll just make it look weird. And then, yeah, phone number change. Kevin Kelly. God, I knew Kevin Kelly many years ago. Went to high school with him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. I think we're good here.
Okay. Actually, you might want to put the hotel contact information if they are to call them. Is there like a special booking information or?
No.
They can go online.
Yes, we're going to provide them that the link so they can register.
Okay. So I thought I remember you saying that you needed a. Rate code, you know, a discount.
Yes.
So
yes,
need to put that somewhere.
So okay.
They'll be calling you, or they'll be like going, "How do I get that rate?"
I understand. Okay.
Okay. And what is the actual rate that they would be getting? Do you know, or is just 30% off of whatever they're
they have a couple different cottages.
Oh, okay.
So once they go in, I'm gonna go ahead and bold out this pilot group.
Yeah, there we go. Good idea. And then www thing that you have in there.
Where, sir?
Go back in there again. So edited it. No, not that one. Yeah, there.
You want to do X out of this?
No. Okay. There's a delay. So.
Oh.
if you hadn't figured that out, it takes, go to
a couple seconds for you to see my screen.
For me to see your screen. So, what I would do is take the inn, or you actually call it Homus House Inn. And
okay.
Type that in there. Then we're going to create a link to it so that they can click on it nice and conveniently.
Okay, so you want me to press done here, sir?
Move your cursor to right in front of N.
In front of N?
Yeah, so guests are asked to contact the...
Okay, I got you. I thought you were talking about IN. Okay, so you want in front of N?
Okay, type Homus House N.
Okay.
Okay, now highlight that. So
I'm gonna link it.
Drag, okay. Right, exactly, drag across it. Okay, now click the link button.
Got it.
Okay, now type in the link.
Okay, I'm going to change this.
Yeah, get rid of the double HTTP.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
It'll mess it up.
Okay.
And then on the target, change that to new window. Okay. If it's ever like a remote website, I always do new windows. I just find it's less obnoxious.
Okay.
Okay. Click OK.
I'm going to put here 1 sec.
Okay.
Okay. Homushouse.com. Okay.
Okay. So now get rid of the www.homushouse.com since you've created the link. You don't need that twice there.
Yes, sir.
And you'll see how that comes up nicely now. So they'll be able to just click on that to do it.
Okay.
And I'm not sure you need the overnight accommodations. It's sort of, it's going to be under hotel.
Yep. Okay.
Okay. Promo group, reserved. Please register early. Okay. Great. Perfect. Done.
Perfect. Phone number, we got it. Let me just double check here. Yes. Okay. All right. I think we're done.
Okay.
Done?
Save that. And then we're done. Yep. That'll save it automatically.
Okay, sir. Let's save this again.
Yep.
And we're going to go ahead and preview it.
Go ahead and click preview.
Okay. Hold on.
Okay, so view details. Okay. So click start.
Yes, sir.
Back to the beginning here.
Yeah, almost how is that
going to be? Okay, so.
Where are we going
to have a new number in there that I'm trying to email us? That must be, I think I know where that is. That's
the 702?
Yeah, the 702 is from the old one, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Question, should we say something on this description about that the arriving aircraft should plan to arrive at a Louisiana Regional Airport and give the identifier?
That's probably a good idea in the description area.
Okay.
Okay, so go back to edit.
I think so. So we don't have someone showing up in Baton Rouge Airport.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, if you put something like transportation will only be provided from plan to show up by such and such time, and transportation will only be provided from this location.
Yes. Plan to arrive. prior to 2 p.m. on Saturday.
Yep.
Okay.
In order to guarantee.
In order to assure.
To assure transportation. To the plantation. And that's included in their cost, or are they paying for that?
No, that's included on the cap in the cost.
Okay. This is included in your cost, you know, or something like that. I always like to make sure they know they're not having to pay for a cab.
Correct. Transportation provided.
Is provided both ways?
So yes, sir.
On the return to?
Yeah, provided by local FBO.
Oh, okay. That's nice.
It's 3 miles. This is wonderful. Everything is very easy. Okay. Okay.
So they'll shuttle them over there and back.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yep.
Scroll up a little bit in there. I would put a carriage return after the period and only period carriage return, just so that you want that to stand.
Right.
Go. And then scroll up a little bit. I was going to put another paragraph break. The inn is activities located on the keep scrolling. Scroll up to the top for a second here so we can
okay.
Spring in the Mississippi. So I'd highlight that, I bold that, the Spring
in the Mississippi,
just to make it stand out. This is now where formatting, you know, just to make it look more attractive.
Yes, but I don't have an option to, I don't see where I can bold it, sir.
Oh, yes, you're right. It's fairly limited in this box.
Yeah.
Okay, then scroll down to, so right after Louisiana. So we're in Darrow, Louisiana. So I would carriage return there, break that out. Okay, and then scroll down a little bit. And then carriage return after accommodations. So I just, because there's limited in terms of making this look pretty, I try to
yes.
it out.
Make it easier to read.
Easier to read okay. for them. And you might do it after gardens again, and the inn is a series. Perfect.
Excellent, sir. Thank you.
Oh, and if you want to highlight that Sunday breakfast will be included, you could break that out into its own line too, just so that, again, it's they don't miss that. People have a tend to speed read these things and they miss
like that
important points. Yeah, yep. Exactly. Okay, now we were still trying to find that stupid phone number.
Telephone number.
Dropping in from somewhere. Okay,
that is Chris, Lieutenant Governor from Texas. That was his telephone number. Does this automatically say, did we just say that word?
You want to hit save down at the bottom.
Yeah, it automatically apparently saved it. But okay, let's go ahead regardless. Save and let's go personal information maybe.
No, I don't think it's under there. Go back to close this. Yep.
Okay, sir.
New events. Click go to the website.
Promote here?
Yeah, under promote, because that's going to be the next place we're going to go anyways, is set up.
Okay.
And it may be.
Where did my, just so I'll know, where did the text and all the information, where's my event right now?
Where is it? It's under event. You're in it. See up at the top under events, it says SC Spring on Mississippi. Yeah. You're in the.
Okay. I was thinking the registration form. Okay, so promote.
Form, just finished. We're done with the form. So go to the website now.
Yes, sir.
I'm not seeing it yet. There we go.
Okay.
So here's the old one. So you see, there's the phone number. So the contact information over on the right, that's where that's coming from. So edit that. So what I normally do is put email and phone number.
Okay. In the same line?
No, hit return there and then email and then just type, then you just type your, they'll figure it out.
Okay.
Okay, and then done with that. That'll fix that up.
That fixed it, and we're going to edit this.
Okay, so, hit edit on the wine tasting part, and you can control A and get rid of everything.
Oh, this is where we're going to put all of the text. I got it.
Yep, exactly. So control A, click in there and then do control A. It should allow you to select all of it.
Yeah.
So this is where you can get creative in terms of doing a nice, one of the things that I try to do is include a bunch of pictures and, this is what's going to sell it.
Yes.
The other part is just informational and so that they can get to it and do all of that stuff.
Let's see. A couple of things that we said that we would add. Okay.
So don't worry that you're repeating stuff. Again, remember this is going to be the page that they're going to see first, and that's going to sell it. And it's not a problem that you're repeating the stuff on the registration, because some people may just see this and go straight to the registration too. So
yeah,
it's not a problem that you're duplicating information here. Now, what you want to try to do is avoid this being like a mile long too, if it's a lot of information. So one of the options is to take the schedule, what I call the logistics, and the hotel information, and move it to separate tabs. So go ahead and save this, and I'll show you how to do that before you finish this all up.
Let me do something very quickly here. They will be included to hotel guests. The fonts are not the same, so let me go ahead and get this right.
Yeah, this is, you can pick whatever font that you want, but you want it to be consistent.
Yes, and let's do the same thing that we did earlier. Do you want to do that?
Before you do that, let me show you something, because you may not want to do this here. So click.
Okay, yes, sir.
Click done for a second.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, click done. And I'm still seeing it said save successfully. I want to go back to the other screen here. There we go. Okay, so see up here where it says website navigation? So the second bar. If you click show on that. No.
Okay, one second. I'm trying to website navigation. That's under promote?
No. Look straight ahead, dead center.
Okay.
You see website header?
Yes, sir.
In the gray, right below, it says website navigation.
Yes, sir.
Okay, way over on the right, it says show edit.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so right now, if it says show, it means that it's hidden.
Okay.
So click show, and it will now show it.
Okay.
Okay, so now what you end up with is three tabs.
Yes, sir.
Okay, summary, lodging, and a agenda.
Yes, sir.
And if you click edit, you can change what those say and the order that they say them in.
Okay.
And you can have up to four tabs there.
All right. So you want me to, on the agenda, hit edit, but this edit will just only edit the headings, right?
Yeah, click that edit. I'm not seeing you clicked it yet. It should bring up a page.
Yes, sir. It says summary, lodging, and agenda.
That's what I was looking for. Okay, so you don't really have an agenda, but what you have is logistics. So what I typically do is change that to logistics.
Okay.
Okay, and save that. And you notice you can have a fourth tab if you want.
Yes, sir. I saw that.
Okay. Now, what you can do is this allows you to sort of have a promotional summary page that isn't like really long. And then you can put your lodging information under the lodging tab, and you can put the logistics information under the logistics tab.
Okay.
So this is just doing a little cutting and pasting, basically, from one section to the other. Oop, your keyboard battery is low.
I didn't see that.
I did.
You saw that on the screen? I was looking down. Okay, so going back.
So, like, if you want to move a bunch of this, so what you can do is cut it out of the one page. Click on logistics.
Okay.
And then edit the where it says add content, hide the agenda items, and show the add content. So you don't want it under agenda. You want it under your what you're going to call it, which is logistics. So you're basically flip-flopping those. And then edit that, and then you can paste that information in. So what you might start with is arrive at L38 before 2 p.m. And so I always like spelling this out as detailed as possible for people.
Okay.
Then transport to the hotel and check-in. Provided by, you know, transport provided by the FBO.
Okay.
Then from 2 to 4 is the tour. Then from 5 to 6 you have welcome cocktails at the and what the what's Oaks?
The plantation is lined with oaks, so they're going to set up an outdoors bar for us.
Okay, I'd say that welcome cocktails by the oaks outside provided by it. What you're promoting is both where to look, so where are they, you know, because they're not going to know where the oaks are.
Yeah. Say provided welcome cocktails outdoors. No, welcome cocktails
a welcome reception. How about that?
Yes.
Welcome reception.
On outdoors.
Yeah, outside. By.
Under the oaks.
Under the oaks.
Okay.
Okay. And
okay, go ahead.
Dinner starts at 6:30. Is where, you know, again, repeat where the dinner is, just so they understand that this is.
Actually, we need to make a change. I'll edit this on the other dinner. Do I need to put the name of the room? Is that what you want to do?
I would put the name of the room where it's going to be.
Okay.
And I put a little, again, this is selling. So I put, you know, this could be where you want to put the menu, you know, that you had.
Okay.
And if there's a photo, perfect place to put a photo.
Again, I don't have a photo, remember, but
does the restaurant, do they promote it on their website?
Let's do this real quickly. We might be able to find something that maybe someone has.
Yeah.
First column?
Yeah.
Okay.
You could use that. I mean, that's at the site. I know it's not, you're not going to be outside.
Yes.
But that's a, that gives them a sense of the classiness of it.
And we're going to insert.
Yep. Click on the picture icon down lower left there. Yeah, that one. So here's a little trick now. Okay, so scroll down on the first column. And
okay.
The South Central Photos, SC Photos down there. Click on that.
Okay.
Okay, so now you see Majesty Tour and Red Wine.
Yes, yes sir.
So then click Upload.
Got it.
And then click select and find your that photo that you just saved. There it is, cuisine. And click open.
Upload.
And then click upload. And boom, there it is.
There it is. Great.
So dinner in the Green Animal Trophy Room of the Carriage House, featuring amazing dinner by award-winning chef. You don't have to do all of that right now, but you can
edit
back this and dress this up however you want it to be.
Okay.
But you got the basic idea. That's how to get a photo in. Make this look as pretty as you want it to do. Bold the stuff that you want. Put in links to whatever you want to link. And
okay.
And so forth. So click done.
Okay.
And then now back at this screen, you'll see that that's now under your logistics. Under lodging, you can put information, again, the same.
I can go on and edit that.
Edit that and so forth. And ultimately, you're going to have your summary page, your lodging page, and your logistics page all laid out just the way that you want them to be.
And, I need to change the dinner time. So we will go back to we'll go to registration form. Yes.
Yep, you can go back to that.
Yeah. Okay.
Edit registration form. No, it's on. Yeah, there you go.
Yes.
And part of this is just sort of getting the feel for where things are.
Yes.
So is it in the event description? I don't know if you had the time for the dinner in here or not.
It's not here. It's not there.
I don't think it's there. And then in the lodging and travel.
I don't think it's there either.
I don't think you had put the time of the dinner anywhere in here. But in you know, the best thing to do is once you think you've got everything the way that you want, then do the full preview, which is you can actually go to that link and walk through doing a registration just the way that you would expect somebody to do it once it's live.
I think that we added that when we went to the website, and this is where it is, but I can't edit this on this page.
Sure you can. Well, not on right here. You have to scroll up and see where it says edit, custom content edit. Custom content, hide, edit. The gray bars are really critical because it breaks each of these things into sections.
Yes, sir. There. Yes, sir.
And if you're not in a pop-up screen like this where it pops it up, you can't edit it. You're just looking at it.
Yes, sir.
So you're going to have cocktails until here's my suggestion also. So you're editing this under the summary page. And what I would do is get rid of this on the summary page and have it just on the logistics page.
Okay.
The summary page should be just that. It should be a summary of the,
Let me go ahead and grab this.
And you could actually control Apple X will delete it, but put it into the clipboard. And then when you go over to the other, you can paste it in, and now you know it's gone from this side.
I'll delete it in a second. So we're going to go back to logistics and edit.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. Now you're getting the hang of where to go.
And I'm upload the menu.
Did you
later.
Wipe out? I don't. You looked like you wiped out the picture, but maybe it's just below where I can't see it.
Oh no, it's there.
There. Okay.
And summary. We'll go ahead and edit that summary.
Yeah, so I would get the summary. I'd get the big chunks where you want them.
Yes.
And then go through and edit it carefully to be exactly what you want. And then go out, save it all, then go out and review and make sure it looks the way that you want it to look.
And, okay. So we are saved.
So at this point, if you go back to the registration form.
Yes, sir. Okay, Peter.
Okay, so you see here where it says create test registration. That's one option. That's one way of going through and doing a test on it. And this brings up, you know, as if you're right at the registration, but you notice it does not bring up the website first.
Okay,
so close that. Okay, go back to website. I want to just double check.
Can we double check this map and directions?
use this event website starting for event. So you do have that checked off. And yeah, you can click, if you go to preview,
okay.
And now you can click on it and it'll act like it's as if you're doing it for real.
Yep. It's on the right. Okay.
Okay. So that brings you up to where you're going. And that's really a good thing to do. I'd recommend that you do that on like all of your links and stuff, just to make sure that you got
everything
right. So if you click on lodging right now, so that's going to bring up your lodging page. So you haven't put anything there in lodging yet. And if you click logistics,
okay,
there's what you've got in logistics so far.
Yes.
Okay. Then you can always go back to edit and continue your process. When you're all done, you want to send to the people that you want to test that, which you can send it to me.
Okay.
I don't know if you want to send it to Gil or one of your...
Where is the button to send that tester?
Okay, so what I would do is simply send them the link information. So if you go back to registration form.
Okay.
And on the start page, so edit the form.
Edit the form?
Yep.
Yes, sir.
You go all the way down to the bottom. You'll see down here, where is it?
Too far down.
No, maybe it's
right here. Registration form URL?
Yeah, there it is. The registration. So you send that link. So the HTTPS /// regonline.com/SC Mississippi Spring.
Okay. All right.
So send that as a link to the people you want to test, and then they can go through it all just like they were registering and
yes, sir,
let you know if they see, you know, a misspelling or anything else. Then once you're all done, then you come back in and, you know, fix anything that needs to be fixed, save it, and then you go in and you actually turn the registration on. And you know how to do that, right?
No, sir.
Okay, so go back to the main, so go ahead and click on that.
Okay, click on?
You were putting in that link.
Okay, yes.
So wherever you went back to the old...
Uh-huh, I'm on the tab, okay. Yes.
Oh, there, so that's what you're going to see. So it brings you up into the website first, which is what it's supposed to do. And this is what people are going to see. Okay, and all the links should work and everything should be active there.
Yes, sir.
So my point being is, you notice how long this becomes. That's why you want to take some of the summary stuff and move it to lodging and logistics.
Yes.
And then you'll be all set.
But how do I actually turn this on?
Okay.
For everybody else.
So the way you turn it on, go back to Spring on the Mississippi. There you go. So close this. So hit the X.
Activate. Oops.
And you'll see. Activate. Activate. So don't click that yet.
Yeah.
Okay. And actually, go ahead and click on it for a second. We're not going to
activate.
It won't activate it right away. It'll bring you to another screen.
Okay. Press and activate. Okay.
Okay, so here's your to activate. You basically have this activation fee $0, registration fee $3.45. That's you notice you don't have a change. Do not, you don't need to change the activation option, so you don't need to check that. And then you would hit the activate button. And then boom, it's activated, and it will be listed as a South Central event automatically over on the COPA site. That's why the SC dash in the front of it is very important.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So
which we have everything, right? Yes.
Yep. Hit cancel since you're not quite ready to activate it.
Okay.
And then the other thing that you can do, so there's two ways to promote it, is you can write a blog on the COPA site and put the link to the site on that.
Okay.
Okay. So people know to go to that, because this is going to show up, open up COPA for a second. So click on South Central. Okay, scroll down a little bit. So you'll see national events there first.
Yes.
Okay, keep scrolling down. Okay, and you'll see safety programs. And you'll see, so you don't have any events. Say, I have mine set up so my regional events are the first thing that shows up. And so I have upcoming events, Pella, North Central, then the national events, then the safety program, and so forth. So that's the way my page comes up. So that's interesting that that's sort of customized, I guess.
Well, I'm gonna edit the tabs, so I can do break that from the summary and put it on the lodging, especially the logistics we got covered.
Yep.
I'm gonna try to get some more pictures in it, and send some emails, some regional emails, and try to get this booked up this week.
Yep. So go to invitations.
Invitations. Okay.
Up at top.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Once it comes up here, I'm not seeing it yet.
It hasn't come up. It's pulling up. Okay.
Okay. So you'll see that you'll see my North Central Churchill flyout. Okay, and COPA and so forth. So you can add an email that, and then over here, click on contact list. So click the plus sign over on the list there.
Yes, sir.
No, not over there. Down lower. Oops. Cancel that.
Yes, sir.
So down, see right where it says COPA membership 2015-140.
Yes, sir.
Okay, not there. Click the plus. Click the plus.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Now,
okay, I got it.
There's yours. So there's, if you're going to send this out to the Southeast only, that's the mailing list you want to send it to.
Okay. And I can send it from here, right?
So what you're going to do is add an email invitation. So that one over there to the big button to the on the top center. Go ahead and click on that.
Okay, add an email invitation. Okay.
Okay, so create the invitation name.
Okay.
So you can say,
set up now?
SC Mississippi.
SC dash again?
Dash, yeah, sure. Mississippi Spring. Event.
Okay.
Okay, and then subject line. This is what's going to actually be in the subject line. So you might put a Baton Rouge spring event, or you know, how whatever you want the email to show up and see.
Okay.
Okay, it's going to be from you. Then down here at the event, click on that.
Okay.
Okay, so this is scary.
Oh.
Yeah, so what you want to do is find your Mrs. the event that you just created.
Okay, and it would be here, right?
Probably down towards the bottom. I wish they could clean this thing up. There it is. Spring on the Mississippi. So click on that. So it's key that you have the right event.
Yes.
Tagged. Okay. It requires that. Then,
okay.
Then the contact list, click into that drop down. And this also is a big, long, scary list. No, not create. Not
yes,
create.
Sir. Yes, sir.
You're not creating, you're using a list.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay. Scroll down to the very bottom. Okay, keep going. Okay, there you see it, the SC 2015-114. Yes. Now that gets updated occasionally, now if you click on theme, you can pick your theme, and then you can do a content, and then do your delivery. So this you can do the same as the registration form. That's sort of typical.
Okay, but I should do this obviously. We're going to do this
after it's posted. You don't want to do this until you've got it activated.
Okay.
And then you can pick a template or whatever you want to use to do it, or copy information over from your website. That's what I do. And then it'll click on delivery.
To link something, okay?
Yeah, like highlight test.
Yes, okay.
Then click on the link. And
you want me to bring the link to the website to the event?
Right, exactly. Now, of course, the link, right, yeah.
This one?
Yes. Click register now.
Okay.
Okay, now copy that link.
And edit this?
Yep, and then go back to the edit test and change the link to that link. It's rather picky.
Peter, this is, there we go. Now it's clean. Oh, you're so sharp.
Okay, there it's, now it's happy. Okay, so now you've got that test, you can just edit that at some point in time. Then go to delivery.
Yep.
Okay, and you see this, when you're ready is you click in the Send Now button.
Yes.
And you check this checkbox.
Yes,
And then hit Done, and then that will send out the email.
Okay.
Okay, so close that. So just hit the X in the corner there. It's already saved.
It's right there, boom.
And there it is. So waiting for you to fix that up before, so it's in draft. And eventually it'll end up, once you send it, it'll go to the sent emails. And then come back after a while. So click on my Churchill one.
Okay.
And this will give you the statistics as to who it went to and how many people opened it and so forth.
Okay, that's very cool.
You should have gotten one of these.
I think I did.
So how come you haven't signed up?
No, I don't think I did.
You didn't get this?
Uh-uh. Well, you sent it to the whole membership?
Yeah, send it to everybody.
How long ago?
Maybe it went in your junk mail.
No, you sent on February 6th.
Yeah, you should have.
Oh, yesterday. I would have seen it yesterday.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe you've opted out of your Cirrus emails. That's the only reason you should.
No, I don't think so. I didn't block it, I promise.
Yeah.
Oh, Peter, you've been very, very helpful.